Hello, welcome to the War Rogers News Channel. Thank you for watching. All right, let's go ahead and look at PokeMMO Puppy Patrol, which is an OU tournament. All right, we're going to be spectating Yabel vs. Belber Boy. So we will be right back. Please stay tuned to the War Rogers News Channel. All right, we are at turn number one. Yabel vs. Belber Boy. Okay. This match might be interesting. Okay. There might be a switch someplace. Oh, there's a substitute. Okay, so Metagross is going to go directly for the Psychic. Somebody is going to switch. That's my prediction. Also, another note, Sceptile has substitute. So, I'm not too sure if this Sceptile is a setup Sceptile. I think I might know what it is. I think it may be an Endeavor set, right? Well, let's see. There's no leftover recovery, according to the log. So yeah, it could be an Endeavor set. Ooh, block! Nice. Oh, meta. Completely paralyzed the competition. Sorry, Chansey paralyzed the competition, aka Metagross. Okay. Wow. And Chansey has been badly poisoned. Okay, so far what we know about this Metagross is that it has Psychic, Block, and Toxic. Okay, so Chansey is going to dwindle down in its health a little bit. Now, I think Chansey's going to try to pull off some Seismic Tosses. Ooh. Alright. So now we know what set this Metagross is. It is a Psychic, Block, Rest, and Toxic. Wow. GG on that Chansey. Not GG on the match, though, because, you know, there's still a lot more that needs to happen. Alright, so Metagross is probably going to wake up sometime soon and then do another rest, assuming that there's a Toxic out there. Chansey can try to soft boil, but it's not... Chansey's efforts are not really worth it. That's what I think, personally. Metagross has the upper hand here. Metagross has the upper hand. And Chansey is pretty much stuck. There's no way Chansey can switch. Chansey cannot escape. And here comes another rest. Chansey's going to try to do a Seismic Toss. There we go. Oh, I said that before the move even came up. Alright, so Chansey's going to faint. And Sceptile might come back and probably do another substitute, right? Since Metagross is resting, I think this would be a perfect opportunity for Sceptile to do a substitute. I really think this is a great opportunity. Alright. Yeah. I am seriously thinking sub Endeavor. Well, if Sceptile can get that far. Alright, so Metagross is going to switch into Weezing! That's an interesting name for a Weezing. And since there's no leftovers, yeah, I kind of knew it was an Endeavor set. I mean, you can just kind of tell based upon how much damage Sceptile is taking. You can tell based upon the fact that Sceptile is not doing any leftover recovery. Which tells me that Sceptile might have a Salac Berry, possibly. Yeah. I think that this that subtile had a berry on it. Okay, I could be wrong, and I think Subtile wants to be used for the last moment in the match, whenever when things count. Alright, so Haunter, I think, is going to scare out Weezing, because Haunter probably has Psychic on it. Magneton. Interesting choice. And Haunter, the substitute. Now, some Haunters carry HP fighting. I think this applies to UU, but since Haunter got moved to OU, I think that it would be plausible if Haunter carried HP fighting, specifically for Chansey and Magneton. I think Haunter's going to switch, because Haunter can't really do anything here. And Magneton can just keep doing Thunderbolt. Now, what Haunter can switch into, that I don't know. Yabel has some serious trouble because one of his special walls, and in my opinion, I think it's the most important special wall, Chansey, got knocked out thanks to the Metagross. Okay, so Haunter is probably going to, well, Shadow Ball. Okay, there's a Thunderbolt. Thunderbolt is going to prove fatal. Okay, Subtile family. Subtile probably has Earthquake on it, so Subtile is probably going to do a substitute and then get the berry boost. Or Giga Drain. Wow, it didn't even have a Life Orb on it. That's interesting. Alright, so which one's faster, Blaziken or Subtile? Let's see if I can look this up really quickly. Alright, Blaziken. Blaziken's base speed is 80. And how about Subtile? Let's see if we have a winner. Alright, the speed is 120, but Subtile didn't want to take the risk. Okay. Wow. Blaziken did a lot of damage to that Milotic. I have a gut feeling that this Blaziken is probably going to switch, predicting a water move. I don't know. It's just my gut. All right, Metagross is going to come back, and now the cat is out of the bag, and now Yabel knows the secret of this Metagross, which means my Milotic is probably going to switch into something that can handle a bulky Metagross. Let's see here. What do you think is going to happen? Alright. My Milotic is going to switch into Blaziken. And Metagross is going to switch into Chansey. Oh boy. Maybe this is the time that Yabel finally catches up. That time has not come yet. Okay. If you ask me, Blaziken is probably going to switch, because if it stays in on the Starmie, then it's basically committing suicide. My Milotic could be a possibility. Oh, Fortress. Wow. That was a nice hit. Nice hit. Oh boy. Now, Starmie could do Thunderbolt, predicting Milotic. I think Yabelle should switch into my low tick if you ask me, but maybe he has some other trick in his sleeve. Alright, so what is Bellibur Boy's Chansey gonna do? Well, Chansey, actually looking at his team, the only Pokemon immune to poison or immune to toxic is Fortress. Chansey could do a Thunder Wave to paralyze the Milotic. Do I think that Milotic is going to do recovery sessions? That's a bit of a stretch. But I think it could be possible. All right. So if you ask me, Bellibur Boy has a lot more flexibility. So due to that flexibility, I think that that the Bellibur Boy he kind of won this match. I'm going to predict that there's a chance he's going to switch into Starmie, and my Milotic's going to do recover. Alright. So my Milotic is going to switch into Fortress. And ooh, nice. Well, I guess Fortress is in a Starmie is not restricted to one move anymore. Now, I think Starmie is faster. I think Starmie can easily pull off an Ice Beam on this. But here's the thing that Bellibur Boy needs to be concerned about. We already saw Endeavor. Do you think that this Sceptile has a berry on it? Well, we're about to find out right now. That's interesting. Hey, it has no berry. that's interesting. I wonder if it just has Miracle Seed on it then. I mean, I don't see it taking away. I don't see Sceptile's health decreasing, so we know that it doesn't have Life Ball on it. I think Bellibur Boy might pull in Chansey. I think Chansey would be the likely case scenario. Alright, Chansey's gonna pop in. I kinda think that Sceptile's gonna be doing Endeavor. That's an interesting move. Especially whenever when Sceptile does Endeavor, that's kind of interesting. Okay, so Sceptile might continually do Endeavor, and Chansey might fall for the trap and do Seismic Toss, and then Sceptile does another substitute, and then Sceptile can pretty much Oko. Not Oko. No. Not Oko. What do they call it? I guess it's T. THKO. THT. Well, actually, you can also apply it to 3-hit KO. I guess I'll just stick with 2-hit KO. Yeah, if Sceptile goes over to the 1 health, then you can pretty much guarantee 2-hit KOs on a lot of stuff. Alright, so Subtile's gonna switch into Blaziken for some reason. And Yabel is making a comeback. Kind of. He's still in a bit of a trouble, but at least he's not in a dire situation right now. In fact, the situation looks quite promising for Yabel. Ooh, wow. Now, I'm going to predict that Starmie is either going to do a Surf or a Thunderbolt or Ice Beam, predicting Subtile. I'm thinking that Starmie might do Surf, which I have a clutch that Blaziken is going to switch into Milotic, predicting the Surf. Alright, so Starmie is going to switch into Metagross, predicting the Milotic, right? Alright, so Milotic's gonna come in. Metagross might do Toxic. I mean, anything at this point in the game can be Toxic, because there's no Steel types anymore. So that means that Metagross now has the floor. Yabel could switch his Milotic into Blaziken, but then Belber Boy could predict that and go directly for Psychic. It's going to be a little risky. Alright, Subtile. I guess he's, I almost forgot, Metagross is asleep. Hidden Power. Probably Hidden Power Fire, if I had to guess. I'm not too sure what Subtile is holding, to be completely honest with you. I think Belibra Boy might do Toxic. I think Toxic might be a possibility. Surf. Oh! You know that there's trouble coming here, so yeah. I'm gonna predict a Toxic here. Or Rest, then Toxic. Because Surf seems to be pretty dangerous. I think Yabel is just kind of hoping for a crit right now. I don't see Yabel winning this match anytime soon. To be honest with you, but maybe he can pull a comeback. Alright, so... Okay, so... Metagross is probably going to do a Toxic. Yeah, Toxic. And we know that Metagross has Block. But we also know that the Metagross also has Toxic as well. Here comes the Toxic. And... I'm going to say that Metagross is probably going to do a rest here. There we go. Don't want to be tongue-tied. Especially in this point in the game. Alright, so... Metagross is doing a really good job for Belibra Boy. If the match continues like this, then I'm going to have to call the match directly to Belibra Boy. Wow. Look at how this match is shaping out. It's pretty amazing. And Yabelle is probably hoping for some more crits, if you ask me. Metagross is probably going to go for rest again to stall out the Milotic, so that Milotic can faint due to the Toxic. Alright, so... Oh, if that was just a crit... Oh, man. That would have been so much better for Yabelle. Well, looks like his Milotic is not going to live this. Wow. Okay, so Blaziken is probably gonna... Blaziken or Sceptile. Okay, so Sceptile is probably gonna use Endeavor, and then Blaziken might come in to the rescue or something. There we go. Alright, so Metagross is fast asleep, and Sceptile is probably gonna do a HP Fire, which I think Belibra Boy could switch into Blaziken, predicting the HP Fire. And he didn't do that. Okay, so now Blaziken... I think Blaziken coming in... Either Blaziken or Starmie could finish out. Now... Sceptile... It's going to be a little tight for Yabelle. Can he still win? Yes, but on a smaller margin now. There's a smaller margin of Yabelle winning rather than Belibra winning. In fact, the chances of Belibra winning is now a much larger margin now. Which means that I am going to have to call the match to Belibra Boy. Congratulations, GG. You won this fair and square. And nice Metagross. Nice Metagross. I can tell you that right now. The Metagross is what determined the match right away. So GG. Belibra Boy is going on the way to the finals. GG. Alright. Belibra Boy has defeated Yabelle. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to the PokeMMO Puppy Patrol. There we go. Oh, we can actually spectate this finals match if this one is done. So we'll be right back. Please stay tuned to the Roy Rogers News Channel for more of your commentary content. All right, we are back. Second semifinals. It's not too often that we can actually get two semifinals, both semifinals matches. But this is one of those times. So let's go ahead and commentate on it as effectively as possible. So, we're going to start off by having both sweepers, I assume their choice banders, switching into walls. Okay. Weezing is going to switch into Venusaur, and Milotic is going to go Surf, but Venusaur, it's just not going to be effective against Venusaur. Okay. Milotic is going to switch into Tentacruel. Interesting choice. Alright, so there's the Leech Seed. Leftover Recovery. I'm going to predict that the Tentacruel... There we go. Tentacruel is going to do an Ice Beam. Let's see. Can Leech Seed actually work on Venusaur, or will the Liquid Ooze ability... Yeah, I kind of knew that was one of the worst mistakes that Kaneo can do. You're kind of killing yourself, Venusaur. You're killing yourself. I don't know why Venusaur is doing this to herself. it's a female, so that's why I said herself. I was about to say himself, because most starters are males. Alright. You know, don't leech seed a tentacruel. Just don't. And you're seeing the reason why. So, alright, so the pursuit did hit pretty hard. Skarmory's going to come in. I'm going to predict maybe a Thunder Punch. Or maybe, is this Metagross Choice Banded? Maybe. Is this Metagross Choice Banded? If it's Choice Banded, then Metagross is going to switch. If Metagross is not Choice Banded, then they can do a Thunder Punch. Alright, so it turns out that Metagross, I can predict, is a Choice Band. Alright, so Skarmory is going to do the first layer of spikes. Weezing is probably going to do a Flamethrower. And Skarmory might switch out. Might. Or Skarmory could be a completionist and do the second spikes, which it's not. Oh, I haven't seen Porygon 2 being run too often. Porygon 2 is hardly ever ran, in fact. People don't understand the beauty of a Porygon 2. Porygon 2... Porygon 2 is basically like the... if you can't get your hands on a Chansey, then Porygon 2 would be your second best comp. Alright, so Weezing is going to switch into number 1, which is the Metagross. Metagross is going to be hurt by the spikes. Okay. So, the Surf is going to hit Metagross really, really hard. But the Pursuit is going to hit and prove fatal against Tentacruel. Okay, so Heracross, maybe? I'm going to predict Heracross, because Heracross is going to scare out Metagross. And plus, Heracross has the move Low Kick. Alright, so Metagross is going to do a Heracross is going to do Pursuit. Oh, wow. I guess this Metagross isn't a Choice Band. I thought it was. Like, the way it hit so hard. I mean... Wow. And the Pursuit did fatally kill Heracross. Alright. I haven't seen this person in the competitive scene, so... Yeah, this person is actually doing really well. Kano? I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly. Okay, so Skarmory's gonna come in. Metagross is gonna switch into Houndoom. Second layer is spikes. And Skarmory's probably gonna switch into something that's safe. Something like Milotic. Okay, so... There we go. Alright. Now, this Venusaur could do a Giga Drain. Alright, so now it's just the third layer of spikes. Nice try, Venusaur, but Skarmory's gonna lay down its third layer of spikes, and let's just say that you're not gonna like it at all. There we go, third layer of spikes, and now Skarmory has free reign over most of the party here. Alright, so... Skarmory doing Whirlwind is a bit of a far stretch. I think that Skarmory wants to stay safe from a Thunder Punch. unless Skymary is the only wall that that Ketchup has. Alright, so Thunder Punch is going to be super effective, and I predicted this, that Skymary would do some sort of Whirlwind or Roar or whatever. Alright, so Venusaur got hurt by the spikes, and Skymary, let's see. Venusaur is going to go into Metagross. Metagross is going to be hurt, and Metagross is down. While Skymary does rest. I have not seen too many Skymaries with rest. But it's a very useful move because, you know, you can recover and, you know, it's just a wonderful move. Now, since the Flygon switch in, went directly into Skymary, that's a bit concerning. Because Flygon could do a Fire Punch right here, which is what Ketchup is expecting. Turns out the Flygon is going to do Giga Drain, which I have no idea why a Flygon would run Giga Drain. But, you know, this person's going to try to do a mixed Flygon. Wow. So Milotic is going to go directly for the Recover. And Venusaur. Alright, so Milotic is going to switch into Skymary. Venusaur could do HP Fire, right? Or Leech Seed. Now, if I were Kaneo, I would go directly into Houndoom. There we go. Oh, man. Okay. Ketchup and Kaneo have one hidden Pokemon, respectively. Houndoom is going to go directly for the Pursuit, and Porygon2 is going to switch into Milotic. Houndoom could go for the Crunch. Or Houndoom can just switch. I think that Houndoom is going to switch into Venusaur. Now, if Milotic has Ice Beam, it can predict that and go directly for Ice Beam. Ooh, nice. Destiny Bond. That's just great. Now Milotic has to be really, really careful. Now, Milotic can't just knock out Houndoom right away. I think Milotic is being a little extra careful to make sure that Milotic does not knock out Houndoom right away. Now, there's a Crunch. And Milotic's gonna go directly for Recover. Milotic is running scared right now. Milotic is trying to exhaust all of its options, that way. Ketchup is really nervous right now because this Houndoom has Destiny Bond on it. And one wrong move means Milotic is down for the count. Milotic is knocked out. So Houndoom is going to go directly for the Crunch. Milotic's going to go directly for the Recover. Okay. There's the Crunch. How am I many recovers does my low tick have? What, 10? 16? 16, right? Probably 16 recovers. Alright. Vaporeon's gonna come in. Vaporeon has lost its spikes, or sorry, has lost health due to the spikes. Where's the recover? There goes another substitute. Cover. Ooh, growth. Okay, something tells me this Vaporeon's gonna hit kinda hard. Kind of. And I was right. My Milotic has Haze, which means it neutralizes the growth increase. There's the recover. Milotic is probably going to go for Haze, which is why Vaporeon is probably going to do Substitute, predicting the Haze. How many recovers does this is Milotic have? It's probably PP maxed on that, if I had to guess. Which makes this Milotic an excellent staller. Just keeps recovering over and over and over again. Something tells me that this Milotic has some PP investment in it. Okay, so probably Hidden Power. Yeah. Alright. And Haze, there we go. At this point, this is kind of like a circle. So Vaporeon is probably going to do... Vaporeon's probably going to do Substitute, predicting the Recover. Alright, I am back. And I see that the battle has hardly changed. Actually, come to think of it, Swampert has been exposed, and Houndoom has been knocked out. But, other than that, the match has not changed since I was temporarily gone. And here comes the Milotic Vaporeon War, where, alright, there you go. Vaporeon's probably going to do a Hidden Power, right? Well, Milotic is probably going to do a Haze. Wow, you can almost envision this match in your head. And then Milotic is probably going to do Recover, and the loop is going to start all over again. Alright. Brace yourselves for HP Electric Vape, and then Haze Milotic. Just brace yourself. Watch this. Haze? Okay. Now, Vaporeon probably does a substitute, and Milotic is probably going to do a recover. Milotic is probably going to switch. I'm glad that the ketchup is adding a bit of some variety. Otherwise, it would have been an endless loop. Alright, so what is Swampert going to do? Well, Swampert could do Earthquake, which could affect Vaporeon. Vaporeon could do Surf, which could hit Swampert a little hard. Alright, so Swampert is probably going to Alright, Vaporeon's going to switch, predicting the Earthquake, right? Rock Slide. If I had to guess, the reason why Ketchup did Rock Slide was probably because of the Weezing. And okay, Flygon's going to come in, and Swampert is going to switch into Skymary, which is still resting. Flygon could either do, well, I think Flygon should do Fire Punch, but this Flygon might be mixed, so it might do Flamethrower. I don't know. Or Fire Blast. Does not look like Porygon 2 is going to survive, and Milotic is going to be coming back into the scene. Milotic is going to probably do a Giga Drain, or not Milotic, sorry, Flygon. Either a Giga Drain or Flygon is going to switch into Vaporeon, predicting the Water Absorb. At least hoping for it. I don't know why Kanano didn't just switch into Vaporeon, so that way Vaporeon could get a bit of some recovery. That was a flaw. Okay, so Skymary's gonna come in. Venusaur is gonna do a Synthesis, and I'm gonna predict either Weezing or Flygon is gonna come in. Sleep Talk. I did not know that Skymary came equipped with Sleep Talk. Usually Skymary comes equipped with Rest, Drill Peck, Spikes, and Whirlwind. Or Roar. Roar. Okay. Alright, so the Leech Seed is going to sap some health, and Flygon's probably going to do a Fire Blast, if I had to guess. Yep. Fire Blast is on the way. Ketchup is in dire trouble right now. Now, this Flygon could do Giga Drain. There we go. Giga Drain is four times. It's going to hit Swampert four times, which means that it'll prove fatal. Wow, I didn't even know there was such a possibility as a four time as a physical Flygon. As a mixed Flygon. I never knew that would be a possibility. Sorry for my long absence. Let's go ahead and go into the finals, which is going to be Kanano vs. Bellibrar Boy. So we'll be right back. Please stay tuned to the Roy Rogers News Channel for the final battle commentary. All right, we are here. There we go. I had to PM both contestants to make sure they were still in the match, because I was kind of a little bit worried that their AFK timer might run out. All right, so or that their timer for their sign up is going to run out. So that's why I've been PMing both opponents respectively. Getting a little bit worried. All right, so Ludicolo is going to come in. The Earthquake. Now, if I had to guess, this is probably the special Flygon that we saw earlier. Well, actually, in the previous match. Now, I've been gone for a long period of time. I don't want to get into the reason why, but I've been gone for a little bit. So, so there's a little gap in that battle where I may not commentate. But I did want you to be able to witness what happened in the battle. So there we go. All right. So Venusaur is going to switch, and Morning Sun. Okay. Arcanine is going to switch to Ludicolo. There's the Earthquake. I have a gut that Ludicolo is going to switch, predicting the possible sludge bomb. No? Yes. Okay, Ludicolo is going to switch, predicting the sludge bomb. Or the potential sludge bomb. Alright, so Flygon could now do Fire Blast. Or maybe not. Wow, there's a lot of party dancing, I gotta tell you that. Now, in the previous match, we all know that this Houndoom could possibly hold Destiny Bond to it. So, yeah. Bellibrar Boy better be careful. Alright, so there's the Flamethrower. Flamethrower is going to be super effective, but Venusaur is able to wall that and do a Leech Seed, which means Arcanine is going to be sapped of its health, and Arcanine could switch out, so that way Arcanine can refresh the Leech Seed. In other words, switching out so that way Arcanine can cancel out the Leech Seed. Okay, sorry about the technicalities here. Okay, so Venusaur could do a Leech Seed, maybe. Okay, so there's the first layer of spikes. Spikes. Second layer of spikes. And there's a Thunderbolt, which is not going to be a knockout, which means that Skarmory could lay in the third and last layer of spikes. I don't know why Belibor Poise is withholding his Skymary, but it's probably for a good reason. Alright, so this Metagross probably... This Metagross probably has some sort of interesting move. Chance he's going to switch into Ludicolo. Flygon's gonna switch again. Alright, so Ludicolo's gonna try to Giga Drain. Giga Drain is 4 times resistant. Venusaur is 4 times resistant to Giga Drain. Okay, so Skymary's gonna come in. Venusaur is gonna do a Sludge Bomb, but it won't affect Skymary because Skymary is Steel type. Okay, so Skymary, third and last layer of spikes. That's my prediction. Third and last layer of spikes. Venusaur is probably going to switch into Houndoom, probably. Yep. Okay, and Skymary is not going to be laying down the last layer. That's an interesting train of thought. Now, is this Doom a Destiny Bond Doom? Let's see. It is. And I think Kanano kind of exposed that a little bit too late. Because now Arcanine's going to try to work around Houndoom. Alright, so Toxic, and Toxic's gonna be hurt by, so that means Houndoom's gonna be hurt by poison, and Arcanine won't be tainted in any way, shape, or form. Alright, so Kanano's gimmick has finally lost its touch, because, you know, if you learn something from running a gimmick, is that it eventually loses its touch. And then people kind of realize, yeah, that's a Destiny Bond. And then they immediately act upon it. Alright, Thunder Punching the Ludicolo. Now, Ludicolo, I'm not sure if this Ludicolo has Rain Dance or not. I think it should, but it doesn't. Okay, so Ludicolo is going to switch it to Jolteon. Well, I don't think it does anyways. Maybe it might. Ooh, Volt Absorb, nice. Alright, so Metagross is probably going to switch into Flygon, predicting a Thunderbolt. Jolteon could do a Hidden Power, predicting Flygon, depending on if the Hidden Power is Ice or Grass. Alright, Jolteon's going to do a Growth, which means that Jolteon's special attack stat increases by +1. And Venusaur is probably going to, Venusaur could probably do, I think Venusaur is going to stay around and do maybe a Leech Seed, maybe. Belibor Boy better switch out of his Jolteon. I know something isn't good. I know something coming up, and it's not that good. Either Leech Seed or constant PP stall. Those are my two things that I'm thinking of. Leech Seed or PP stall. Both of us know that, well, depending on how many people are watching, on the YouTube video, if you, on this YouTube video, if you're watching this with about 3 or 4 guys, then, you know, then that means I'm going to say this. Me and everyone that's watching We all know that that a Thunderbolt growth plus one special attack cannot knock out Venusaur under any circumstance, unless Venusaur is like in dire health. Yeah, it can do a dent, but I don't think it can really do a knockout. That'd be a little much. Alright, so Vaporeon's probably going to do Substitute. Now, this Vaporeon, I could be wrong, but I think this team, you know what? I just thought about something. This team is a copy of the previous team and the semifinals. If that's the case, then the Kamneo is in a world of hurt, because there might be someone from Belibor Boy's team that might scout the living daylights off of Kamneo. There's a Thunder Punch. Thunder Punch is going to hit Ludicolo. Ludicolo is going to do a Surf. It's going to be critical. Okay. This does not look good for Kamneo. It looks good for Belibor Boy, but it doesn't look good for Kamneo. There's a superpower. But without a choice band boost, it's just it's not gonna hit as hard. Alright, so Venusaur is going to come in. Venusaur is going to be affected by the spikes. Giga Drain is not going to be effective, but it's critical. Look at how much that critical did. Barely anything. So this Ludicolo is probably going to switch into Arcanine, right? Oh, Metagross. Now, if this is the same Metagross as the one in the two matches ago, then we know that this Metagross has Block, Toxic, Psychic, and Rest. Well, I guess that's not the same Metagross. Alright. Meteor Mash missed, and Weezing can be able to pull off a Will-O-Wisp. So Metagross could switch, or could do Psychic, depending on if this Metagross is mixed or not. Alright. Nice prediction. Nice. Alright, so Arcanine can scare off Venusaur. Venusaur might go into Vaporeon. Weezing. That's an interesting choice. If I was Kanano, I would go directly into Vaporeon, because Vaporeon can withstand a flamethrower. And looks like Arcanine is going to take Weezing out. This situation does not look good for Kamneo. And now it's time to go directly into probabilities here. You see, Kamneo's party is not really too flexible. Belibor Boy's party, you know, he can switch it into anything he wants. And we're gonna predict that Chansey hypothetically has Aromathy. Alright, so there's a little bit of flexibility gone from Belibor Boy's party. But okay. Now we know that this Jolteon could have a possibility of being HP Ice, since it switched directly into there. Alright, so yep, I predicted it. HP Ice. Alright, so HP ice again, right? Boom. Alright, so Vaporeon's gonna come in. Alright. Actually, I think I can safely call that Bellerber Boy is going to win this match. I can safely call it, because HP Ice is going to knock out Flygon and Venusaur. Vaporeon can't really handle a stab Thunderbolt, courtesy of Jolteon, straight in the face. As we see in the battle right now. Okay, so Bellerber Boy has defeated Kenio. Congratulations, Bellerber Boy. Anyways, this is the War Rogers News Channel. Don't forget to comment or subscribe to my channel, like or dislike the content that you see here. And this is the War Rogers News Channel, signing off. Fast, accurate, unbiased, War Rogers News.